Hi my dear friends, how are you all? Welcome back to the channel, it's me yours Robins. Please keep watching, stay tuned and stay safe. Today we are going to visiting the Herod's Palace. This court is called Herodium. Herod's Palace is an archaeological site within the fortress of Herodium in the West Bank, about 12 kilometers south of Jerusalem. Herod the Great commissioned a lavish palace to be built between 23 and 15 BCE atop Herodium for all to see. Herod the Great died of natural causes in 4 BCE. His cause of death is debated, but it is known that he was in both mental and physical disorder in his final years and that he suffered from arteriosclerosis. Herod built swimming pools at all of his 15 palaces. The complex included houses for his clerks, storehouses, administrative buildings, and magnificent gardens. King Herod, sometimes called Herod the Great, was a king of Judea who ruled the territory with Roman approval. While Judea was an independent kingdom, it was under heavy Roman influence and Herod came to power with Roman support. The Bible depicts Herod as a monster who tried to kill baby Jesus and, when he couldn't find him, killed every infant in Bethlehem. Historians today generally believe the story is fictional. While Herod did execute one of his wives and three of his children, he was also a prolific builder who renovated and expanded the temple in Jerusalem, the most holy site in Judaism. He also helped save the ancient Olympic Games during a financial crisis. The story Herod, King of Judah. Biography. King Herod of Judah is one of the most controversial figures in great ancient history. He is known for the Bible story of the massacre of children. So today the word Herod means phraseology cowardly and unprincipled man. However, the king's private portrait would be incomplete if it ended with a reference to the massacre of breastfeeding women. Herod was a group for work on the throne during a difficult time for the Jews. This feature is worth a line next to the king figure that is the opposite of the bloodthirsty killer image. Herod the Great family. At its origin, Herod was not a member of the royal Jewish dynasty. His father, Antipas Idumean, was governor of the province of Edom. By this time, the Jewish people had found their way east, in the Roman expansion. In 63 BC, after Jerusalem has become dependent on the kingdom of the kings of Judah, Pompey is captured. During the civil war in Rome 49 to 45 years, the power in the Antipater Senate had to be decided by Raj. He is supported by Iulius Caesarea. Loyalty has received a substantial dividend as his assistance when he defeated Pompey. Antipater was the promising title of Judea, officially the king's culprit, and in fact the principal Roman governor of the province. Even BC, at 73, future Herodos at Edom the son was born. From the fact that Antipater was promoted, he was the patron saint of King Hyrcanus II, who had a great influence on what he did. It was made by his son Herod the governor of Galilee, with the permission of the king. This 48 BC occurred in when the young man is 25 years old. The first steps in politics along with Herod, the great Roman sovereign, was a loyal governor. Such relations are condemned by the conservative part of the Jewish community. The nationalists wanted independence and did not want to see the Romans at home. However, the external environment was such that only a Jew could protect his aggressive allies under the protection of the Republic. In BC, the Diocese of Galilee as the Parthians have come under attack. They captured Judah and all the helpless people and threw his puppet King Charles into Jerusalem. Herod fled to Rome, hoping to get an army and oust Hyrcanus, where he was safe. This time, His father, Antipater Idumean, died of old age, so the policy was to make its own decisions and act at your own risk. The beginning of the reign, every year of his reign, Herod had a balance between the two polar sections of society. On the one hand, he tried to maintain good relations in Rome, as his kingdom was in fact a province of the empire. At the same time, the king did not want to lose credibility among the citizens, most of which had a negative attitude towards newcomers from the west. Worthy of his dignity and grandeur, and with this reconstruction Herod hoped to gain more support from the Jews. Recent findings suggest that the Temple Mount walls and Robinson's Arch may not have been completed until at least 20 years after his death, during the reign of Herod Agrippa. In the 18th year of his reign, Herod rebuilt the temple on a more magnificent scale. Although work on outbuildings and courts continued for another 80 years, the new temple was finished in a year and a half. To comply with religious law, Herod employed 1,000 priests as masons and carpenters in the rebuilding. The finished temple, which was destroyed in 70 CE, is sometimes referred to as Herod's temple. Today, only the four retaining walls remain standing, including the western wall. These walls created a flat platform is called the Temple Mount, and which the temple was then constructed. Herod's other achievements include the development of water supplies for Jerusalem, building fortresses such as Megiddo and Herodium, and founding new cities such as Caesarea Maritima and the enclosures of Cave of the Patriarchs and Mamre in Hebron. He and Cleopatra owned a monopoly over the extraction of asphalt from the Dead Sea, which was used in shipbuilding. He leased copper mines on Cyprus from the Roman Emperor. Herod was died in Jericho, after an excruciatingly painful, putrefying illness of uncertain cause, known to posterity as Herod's Evil. Josephus states that the pain of his illness led Herod to attempt suicide by stabbing, and that the attempt was thwarted by his cousin. This is the story of King Herod. I hope everybody liked this video. I will be back with another interesting video. Until then, keep tuned and stay safe, and this is signing off by Robbins.